If you don't have a pickup truck, how do you get big lumber like this home? I'm in no way suggesting this is a good idea, but I'll show you how I did it. These posts are 6-inch by 6-inch by 12-foot long. If the post stops at the front seat, it's unstable. I was able to fit one post all the way through the seats. There was just enough room to be able to shift into drive. When I press on the wood outside, it's nice and stable. With both of them sticking out, it was not stable. It was stable because I tied both of them together. And I drove all the back roads to keep the speed down. Over the years, we've built two houses without a truck. Sometimes we've had to get a little creative. Now, like I said, I wouldn't recommend doing this. It's easy to overdo it and break the springs in your car. It hasn't happened to me yet, but I know people that it has happened to. As a rule of thumb, I calculate the weight capacity of a car this way. Every seat holds 200 pounds. And try to distribute the weight equally. Then I do what I can to keep the speed of the car down. This is probably more of a video on how not to carry wood home. What you really need is a friend with a truck.